Theme parks never stand still. That's why we are now going into a news recap for the weeks 50 and 51, 2020. Hey guys, just a quick note. I've launched a Discord server for us. There's just a general channel at the moment, but some specific sub-channels may follow over time to discuss whatever you like to. Link is in the description, feel free to join. 22 cabins for Geiselwind. It has now been confirmed on the freitagparknewsnrw.de website that the large construction site opposite of Geiselwind will be for overnight accommodation. The information comes from a meeting of the local council. According to the park director Melter, there are plans to build 22 cabins as the park's own overnight accommodation offer. The park would like to make the site more attractive for families and see themselves here by following a trend. Even if the park may seem a little small for such an offer at first glance, it may well be that one can successfully persuade families to travel from a greater distance with their own offers. Families with young children in particular often accept only limited travel times for day trips. With an overnight stay, however, the park's reach could be significantly extended. The Netherlands also back in a hard lockdown. According to the Dutch press, the government has also tightened the measures to contain the pandemic in the Netherlands. Accordingly, the amusement and theme parks that are currently hosting a winter season will have to close again. This clearly affects Efteling Theme Park Resort and Theme Park Toverland, as well as other parks and facilities. We all hope that this winter will be the first and last in which we have to miss the millions of twinkling lights of the parks in winter and Christmas spirits. Castle renovation at Disneyland Paris. Via Twitter, the account DLP Report shared that they will also completely renovate the Sleeping Beauty Castle at Disneyland Resort Paris, starting in January 2021. The work is then to be completed in time for the 30th anniversary of the resort in 2022. Since one can assume, presumably, due to further continuing restrictions on shows by pandemic measures, that they cannot perform the Illuminations show at the castle in a timely manner again. The timing, therefore, seems quite favorable for the revision. In addition, in the attached video, they talk about further renovations to existing buildings and attractions, so there's a lot happening at the European Disney Resort besides the novelties in the studios. Wallaby Belgium shows mega coaster test rides. Wallaby Belgium has shown on their own social media channels as well as their own YouTube channel a few short impressions of the first test ride of the new mega coaster. Looks already very good. Are you looking forward to Europe's next Intamin Mega? This one will also include some special never seen before elements like the non-inverting Cobra Roll. For me, this coaster is on top of the list for the season 2021. Also, Theme Park Magic shared some interesting photos on Facebook from which the likely name of the coaster can be deduced. According to the logo that can be seen, the coaster will probably be known as Conda. Plopsaland's Extreme Spinning Coaster celebrates track closure. In Belgium, things are not only heating up at Wallaby, but also at Plopsaland near Belgium's coast. The theme park magic was there and shows not only many pictures of the roller coaster, which is unique in Europe so far, but also reports that the track closure has taken place in the meantime. The crew of RCS probably wanted to finish before Christmas. This coaster is together with the new mega coaster in any case at the top of the highlight list for the coming year, that's for sure. Nigloland confirms water coaster and name through a trailer. That Nigloland in France is building a water coaster is known for quite some time, but now there is finally the official confirmation through a trailer from the park itself. Also, the name Krampus Expedition is now secured. The water coaster from Mack Rides will be built around the already existing Alpina Blitz coaster from the same manufacturer. Furthermore, the park has published some technical data about the coaster on its own homepage. On a footprint of 9,000 square meters, the roller coaster reaches a height of 28 meters. In 4 minutes ride time, it goes over 600 meters of track for up to 850 people per hour, with a maximum of 3.5 G on the journey. That's it for the news recap for the weeks 50 and 51, 2020. Next Sunday, I'll bring you the summary for the upcoming week. If you want to stay up to date, please leave me a like, subscribe or comment, or follow me on my other social media sites.